¿Digo qué?
It's getting set, first and 10.
No, it's Taylor.
And then some, and there's no gain at all for the runner.
And before they can run another play, the clock hits triple zeros. And time is up on the first quarter. Nothing, nothing, our score. We'll return to Cincinnati after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers.
Because of a video. And that's it. Experience is worth nothing in modern age.
It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two. Looking to keep this drive moving.
But it is worth for them to have their own decision.
Yep.
Oh. There.
Steelers are able to strike for six. And they're able to run it in and
Jets got into the battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points. That's going to be a tire for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how they're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown run of 6 yards. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. They'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over the 25. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they'll be led out by the NFL's most valuable player from 2015. It's Cam Newton.
There are a number of great quarterbacks in the NFL. But I have to believe that the prototype in terms of look has to be Cam Newton. That stature and frame, almost breathtaking when you see him in person. And now he's starting to put it all together with consistency in his game, throwing, running, leading.
On first down, Campbell. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles, and his feet never stop moving.
Now a play fake, and it's Newton. And right side, Hitler's got it. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
To throw on second down is Newton. Complete to Jones. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Play action. It's Newton. A minute 57 to go in this first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this. A reminder coming up at halftime, while the two of us head for warmer areas of the press box, we'll be sending you to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Send me to Orlando, please.
And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Head to Tom Jones. In there to get him for a loss of 5. Here's Newton now on second down. Finds a man in a crossing route. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Terrible. Just terrible.
Only good pickup of 28 yards. We often with Cam Newton talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been the throw throughout his career. And the big part about just watching him throw it seems almost effortless.
And caught by Henry. Give him a couple on the catch in second and 8. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved. But when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You got to try and give him some space where he can make a play downfield, or at least an opportunity for some rack yardage right up right after catch.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first to go. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a fair call. Because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. To throw on second down. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to third down. From the 3-yard line again, they'll try and punch it in here on third and goal. It'll be a pickup of just two, and that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. So on is Matt Prater now to try a field goal here. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And the 10-yard back knocks it through the goalpost. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they get three. They were hoping for six. An unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board. Happy. But you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to get back on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation.
Yeah, worth the shot. Ah, 14 short.
First down on the pickup of 11 yards.
And that's how you run the football and run it successfully. Big time chunk of yardage picked up, but why? Offensive linemen wanted the point of attack. They're levered way better than the defenders. The low man wins when you're getting underneath and trying to move people. That's exactly what happened on that play. The offensive line moved the defensive front, created space, and the end result, a fantastic run.
Didn't work out this.
I don't know. Let us try a bow, I guess.
And the Steelers, they're ready to rock on first and ten. On the ground, this is Jackson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
That's a rapid run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
First carry for the 5-10 pro bowler, and Aiden Tomlinson. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, Rio, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big time penetration, and throw people for losses.
West Coast is probably going to do this.
He stopped immediately there. Calling no gain there, and now they're looking at a third and
Let's see, can we restart? And let's try that again. Really need to get away from these guys.
Yeah!
And,
And the offense runs for a first down and 10. In motion left to Sharp. On the handoff, this is Taylor. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Lewis
losing yardage back at the 42. And that'll make it second and 12.
No, I didn't. No.
They need something good to happen right here, right now. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. And some room to work. They send you down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. It'll be a gain of 17 and a Pittsburgh first.
You okay?
But the reasoning is too far for a field goal, and it's too short to really get a big field position edge on the punt. Let's go for it. And sure enough, it's the ground game that's able to convert for them on fourth down.
Well, that's everybody in the box.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Benny Gow. No. And now the offense getting set, first and ten.